Could be this one still. Considering it was pretty stable up until that drop just there, I'm going to consider it a one-off fluke. It usually doesn't happen in the middle of the day like that. It usually only happens at night, so I'm figuring that was just like a one-off dropper. Yeah, I was muted. My delay is like 60 seconds, so I see your chat like way late. I'm so sorry. I have it delay as like a dropout protection, but... if the network literally turns off, yeah, there's not much I can do. So, consider this the start of the episode. Welcome back. We're here with Pokémon Violet, you know. We're gonna go see Violet. We're on our way down south. I apologize for 300 notifications. Kotick's leaving? I'm sorry, I literally just read that other chat. That's really good news. Maybe one of these days we will play Overwatch on this channel. But probably not. Sorry. It used to be my game, I just kind of fell out with it. And then everything else with Activision Blizzard, I don't really want to support that company too much. But if Kotick's out and they really repent, you know, maybe. It's an interesting zone. Everything here seems really low level, so I'm just gonna kinda... oh shit, that guy's not. Oh. These guys aren't low level at all. What the hell is weak against that? That's interesting. It is really interesting.
has a tough stabilizer.
The trouble is why was he there for so long, knowing who that guy is, right? How the hell did he stay on for so long? Who had the power to get rid of him? Nobody? Like, was he literally, like, so ingrained in the company they couldn't get rid of him? Oh, okay. They still had that lawsuit out. They lost, right? And that's why? Oh shit, my typing is wrong. I'm so bad at Pokemon. Yeah. Mel? Oh, crap. How can I get a couple of those, you know? I've got damages. You know, I stopped playing a game I kind of enjoyed because of that. You know, when I was playing the game, he was still called McCree, you know? That's how it be, huh? Horrible people get to keep being horrible as long as they make money. Am I as bad at this game as I think I am? Well, you settle when you basically lose. It's not admitting guilt. Settling is not admitting guilt. But it's an admission that you don't think you can win. This is not really going well. I mean, it's going something, but this is a high-level Sableye, huh? I wish all the people I had problems with could settle instead. Can't talk about it. I literally can't talk about it. Honestly? I'll hit you up. Atticus, hit me on Discord, send me a name. I played Elusive. Reinhardt. I would play Hog too.
He's fun.
Junkrat was fun too. Why did they throw a Gardevoir? That's stupid. Which is bad. Or was I not paying attention? I'm surprised that network crashed out before, because I literally have not dropped a frame this entire stream. That never happens. Like, my signal's so solid right now. How did I even drop? I dropped the first, like, 17 minutes of this episode. It was more like the first 5 minutes because I was, like, pre-streaming. Pre-streaming is part of the show. If you're not jamming to the music, I'm literally sitting here jamming sometimes. I'm like, I got, like, problems. I drink too much of this. That's the problem. Is he gonna avoid this every time I try to hit him? Yeah, big hammer, go swing. Two of those characters. D.Va slaps. D.Va out of the suit, best character in the game. Like, straight up. Mobility, damage, she's great. In the suit, you're kind of just a fucking target, but like, out of the suit, that's where I was always racking them up. You know, the suit was a diversion. When they added Anna, like, I stopped playing the game, like, right around the time Doomfist was entered into the game. That's about where I was done. Not because, like, Doomfist was particularly mid, but because I was kind of bored with it. There was Destiny 2 to be played at that time, and you should understand that. This is not even really an effective move. Yeah. I've really been out of it for a while. I think I even have it, like, installed still. I had just a lot going on, you know? When did Overwatch come out? It was like 2015? 2014, something like that. It's been some time. May? The Ice Girl? Support character that's DPS in disguise. Yeah, feel. It wasn't that he was a melee character, it was just that, like, I didn't get what they were doing with the game at that time, and clearly they didn't really either. It's changed a lot since then, I know that. I'm sorry, what is that weak against? It's been so long since I've actually played, like, a Pokemon video game. I'm trying to figure out what that is. Mahu, whatever. Oh, super effective. Really. Like, I know you're weak to fighting, but, like, I don't think you're weak. I'm pretty sure Aqua Tail is going to be more damage than that. And I'm out of Aqua Tail. Yeah, okay. Yeah, really. Okay. so confused by the level scaling in this game. I really am. Like, I don't... He's like, everybody over here is, like, level 50 or more. So, like, I guess we're supposed to go here next? Like, it feels like a road to two would be a little harder than some of the other options right now. I'm about to go through my Pokedex for real. Can I see my full Pokedex, please? I don't want recents. I want, like... What the f... I'm sorry. I'm confused. Oh, there he is. Haven't I battled that already? I should know at least what it's weak to. Cool. That's a lot of information. Thank you so much. That's fucking helpful. It's probably Gardevoir. Everything's weak to Gardevoir, right? Go. Yeah, I used to play a lot of random too. Oh, it was Gardevoir. I'm so dumb. Standing there for so long trying to figure out, like, what would that be weak to? It's like fighting type, isn't it? And I'm like, it's Gardevoir, right? Why do I have this mon? It's for fighting types. Duh. A 76 too. I know that's like super basic. I mean, he's basically, you know, Call of Duty in my Overwatch. At least I wasn't playing Bastion. I refuse. It's like so dumb. Like super, you like a lot of good utility, but. Widowmaker and Anna. I'm like a sniper freak, I know. Hands. Big hands. I feel like he's probably pretty good. I'll be honest, Combi is not really helping me at all, ever. This guy's literally massive. I Paradon. Get me the hell out of here. So busted. Oh. Go, go, Meridon. Okay, good. It's going south, right? It's like, why is every area so big? See, like, they're all so big, just to be so empty and samey. Like, did this area have to be so freaking big? There's nothing here. This looks like the poop level from Conker. Freaking hear it right now. This game had to be this big because of this dirt bike, I swear. I would so much rather a small, detailed world. Like, the classic Pokemon games did not have a single spare bite. You know what I mean? There was no extra room in that cartridge. Every tile mattered. This is just huge for no reason, you know? At least throw a different texture on the wall. You know, where's like the like unknown cave drawings or something, you know? Like, I don't know. Something. Being huge if it's freaking empty. Like, I remember No Man's Sky a little bit was like that. It's better now. It is. You know, if you're bored, you just take off, but. No Man's Sky, in any given screenshot, anywhere you land, looks 100 times better than this game. And you can take me to court. Is that a challenge? Graphics? My side dog is like, no, I'm gonna have to switch immediately. Oh, it's okay. No, with 13 HP, I'm just gonna... And don't worry about it. I'm just gonna pop a potion real quick. Space games are the best. Put that out there. Freaking earthquake, huh? Why are the trainer battles like 100 times harder than the area they're standing in? Freaking trainer battles and something like that. It is a lot better than even when I started playing it later on. Like, I started playing it like 2020. They've done a lot in the last 3 years, that's pretty impressive. That should be an interesting game. The new Hello Games, you know, I was remarking that. I was like, you know, they got a good 10 years out of their first game. You know, this is the first game they've ever put out. That's impressive. To get that kind of distance and the commitment to the game, you know, to turn around what was kind of a rocky start into, you know, winning game awards for, you know, best running thing. They did a pretty good job, you know? I gotta give it to Sean Murray. He's kinda probably the only Twitter profile worth a shit anymore. He's not a feat about Twitter right now. I didn't realize my Florigato here was like the crux of this battle. If I had realized that, I would have thrown him out like way sooner. You got a freaking Lycanroc now? You had more? I'm going Terra. I'm gonna Terra out. I'm so pissed. I just like, please, stop this. I want out of this battle. This is like popping Gigamax, you know what I mean? Like, I'm just fucking, I'm done, you know? Rock Slide, really? I hate this fucking game. This is like the meanest Pokemon I've ever played. This game is just fucking mean. You know? Just fucking mean. At this point, if I lose this battle, I'm gonna be so tilted. Way to miss now. I'm letting it go up to fate. If I die here, that's it, you know? Fuck it. Oh my god. No freaking way. Dude, I'm so mad. I'm not losing now. I'm not losing like that. You fuck yourself. I'm so mad. So mad. Oh my gosh. Stop. Stop it. Stop. Give me your $3.50 for murdering your Pokemon. Let me get the hell out of here, please. Literally $7. Well, I'll see you later. I tell you what, there's absolutely no way we are challenging Tulip right now. Oh, hey, that's cool. Oh, it's all those classic icons. Oh, I love that. No Gotharita was in this game. I have to catch it. Oh wait, that's dumb.
Literally psychic type.
Thank you. Just kidding. I didn't even kill it. I'm just gonna talk about other battles. I like really stomach it. Thank you.
Poor Growlithe. He's getting knocked out. We are still under level.
Definitely a little bit low.
I expect Tulip to be pretty tough, so. Let's, we gotta toughen up a bit. Honestly, there was pretty good leveling back down in that cave, so. I know Gardevoir can hit this guy.
Hey, what's up? How you doing today? Was that even that effective? I Bruh.
I don't want to hurt him, you know?
There's literally no way he doesn't get caught by that. Oh, come on! He's at, like, 1 HP!
Go ahead, kill Growlithe now. Oh my gosh. Gracious, that was freaking impossible.
Goodness, there's not any stabilizers on here. Thanks. so glad I never got very good in those So, level 40 and above doesn't actually listen to me, so how I'm doing is, like, not listening. And, I'm trying to get strong enough to fight Tulip, but the problem is that I'm literally done out from being able to fight Tulip in this, like, state of... My mons don't listen at the scaling down here. So, like... It kind of sucks. Because it's an open world game, and you think you're allowed to go anywhere you want. And then, it doesn't matter, you still have to do it in the order they designed it anyway. It's a Bethesda-type problem. There's an illusion of choice here, but really there's a proper order. And because the game is so open world, it doesn't feel focused enough. And it's like I end up just being lost while I'm trying to figure out where the game wants me to go. Like, I thought I was gonna go fight Tulip and finish that out, but everything down there is too strong and my mons don't listen. So, like, I'm gonna go to the gym leader over here, and I'm gonna decimate him because I'm far too strong, but it wasn't obvious that I was supposed to go this way yet. Because it still isn't. What is that? What the hell is that? Fuck yeah, I'm gonna pull down that steak. What is that? Cool. A thing. So, am I wrong? Seems so time-consuming. It seems so time-consuming to go all the way around like that. To the point where I think I'm probably just gonna waste more time seeing if I could go this way. Or Team Star is over here. Why? You know? Just like, why? Interesting. I understand those are like rays or something. I'm just like, not really. I'm not really into it right now. It just seems so barren. It doesn't look like a place I want to visit. Oh, it's so strong. So we're gonna check this gym out. Seeing as we couldn't go fight Tulip, I'm sure this will be a cakewalk. Because we are like out of order or something. I don't know what the designed order here is, but I am definitely not doing it properly. Why did you interrupt me? If you weren't ready to fight. Gosh. Nimona's really into me, huh? She'll chase me down wherever. She doesn't even want to fight. She just wants to, like, pretend like she wants to fight. What? This is dumb.
Is there no hints about the secret menu thing?
There's too much stuff to remember. Wait. I just wanted to walk around. Gosh. Thank you. camera here is giving me a hard damage in the brain. What? Huh? I don't get it. Can we just battle? Because I don't freaking get this. You gotta make me figure this out. I have the IQ of, like, a pencil eraser. Are you kidding me? I don't know.
Dude, all I got out of all that was lemon. There's like 6 buttons to hit. Oh, you've gotta be kidding.
I'm so freaking filtered by this, dude. I don't know what the hell I do. I'm sorry, dude. Mm-hmm. Yeah, thanks, and. Am I supposed to be able to get, like, up there? I can't. I really don't get it. There are not enough hints here! There's only one hint! Chickens. I'm not like asking for help, but like I really don't know what the hell we're doing here.
How am I supposed to order the secret menu item? What do you mean?
Huh? I genuinely don't know what the hell we're talking about here. Huh? Oh, you're just a challenger? I guess I was supposed to ask the people outside too. So, is the leader here like a level 30 something?
Like.
But all the surrounding mons are like level 17. Like, what is the scale?
I don't know what I'm getting into.
What the hell
is this dish thing?
I don't get this.
Not understanding.
Look for something that's the odd one out at one of the ice cream stands. They have rice balls. Girl to perfection. Rice balls. Lemon? Maybe? I'm trying to figure it out. I really am. Dark spot surrounded by stairs. What's up? Dark spot surrounded by stairs?
You mean like that right there? In front of you?
Sweet churro? Yo, homie, peppermint mocha latte? I need that now. All I've drank today is battery acid and straight coffee. That sounds really good. No, I'll be real, I went to Cracker Barrel this morning and, every time I go to Cracker Barrel, I go to get that
Oh, look at these two fabulous lads. Oh, yeah. Oh, work it, boys. Oh, look at them, sipping in sync.
They're both switches.
Sorry, I'm moving on. Hey, that looks like help. Two fabulous lads. Hey, we don't judge here in Paldea. It's a visa. Or two Gardevoirs or two Gallades can go at it however they want to, and nobody judges. I didn't mean to rate. Wait, you can actually run from a trainer battle? You can actually quit a trainer battle in this one. Like, quit, like, as if you lost flat, but, like, you can quit a trainer battle. You never used to be able to do that. It would always just say, like, you can't run away, you know? I didn't know you could actually quit in this one. Like, I would have quit that other one and saved myself the time from getting murdered. Crunch. Real. So real. Yes, you do. I need your clue. Blue bird Pokemon. What are you talking about? These clues are getting more esoteric. Fire blast. There's fire blast in the hall, huh? Listen to this, my squawkabilly can talk. Talkabilly. What happened to the people?
I got like 604 questions. There were several people eating here at those tables. What happened to the people? I cannot move any further. What I just saw was peak Game Freak animation. I swear. They didn't even, like, transition that one. It was just like, there are people there at tables, and now it's a stadium. Like, there wasn't even, like, a fade out. Was there? The studio. Dude, they have no they have no animators. I don't think they've hired any animators at Game Freak since, like, Diamond and Pearl. There were people eating there. What happened to them? What happened to the people at the eatery? Can you tell me? Are they dead? They fucking died. What emote is that? Well, I gotta get that added to my channel. Stat. What is this place? Why does a place like this exist? Like, fully modeled like this. With, like, no explanation of what they are. This door is, like, not even human sized. I can't read this! I can't even read English. It's like really, like... Their blood is used to lubricate the gears as it flips over. I still can't get up there, so, like, where's the challenge? Who do I talk to? This guy looks like he hates his life more than I do. What kind of, like, corporate capitalist-ass fucking gym battle is this? This guy's, like, not thrilled to do this at all. Thank you for doing business with us today. Hi, Larry. We'll be at your service. You're the gym leader here? You know that Adventure Time episode? It's like episode 6 when they like thaw out the businessmen? That's literally this guy. This is who they froze for that. Bizarre place to have this battle. Delay I've got? Oh my god, that's way too long. delay is over a minute. He's literally normal type. He's literally basic. Honestly, I've been contemplating just doing that so you can at least see like what I'm replying to. It's just like there haven't been enough people actually chatting for me to justify that yet. But I'll figure out how to do that straight up. If it becomes a problem, it'll be a problem. I can get a mod in here. I can get my gold back killed because I fucked mods. At least then you can see what I'm playing. Even his pupils are square. This actually was like the proper level. I wouldn't have like read that. You know? He sounds like me now. He's like, you're pretty good. I might lose. Yeah, you got customers waiting and a bunch of empty tables because you just murdered everybody that was in here. Twerking? Larry throwing it back? Yo, Larry, drop that ass. Yo. Yo, Larry gonna find us. Sexual content warning on this for Larry's thick ass. You're just like, just murdered the Surrender. Like, what the hell? Who one shot that dude? Oh, he's so sad. Threw me for a loop? That's literally some shit I would say. That's some shit I would say playing cards, I swear. Why this? I've never seen this. They always evolve, like, right out on the screen. Why does this screen exist? If this screen exists, then why don't you play it when other mons evolve? This looks way better than, like, all of a sudden the camera zooms in on a piece of the ground, and you're like, what the hell is going on? And then your mon loads in, and it's like, oh, it's evolving. Okay. And it's like the ugliest sequence ever. What is this? This is awesome. Why don't they just play this? Tangent. Why don't they play this? They didn't even get that. What the fuck? This game is so inconsistent with everything. You had this whole like backdrop sequence, and like you play the ugliest freaking sequence in the world for evolving otherwise. And only if like you very specifically get a mon to evolve in a gym battle, you get this. So the odds are, like you can go an entire play, like an entire save file with never seeing that this sequence even exists like this? 10 out of 10, Game Freak. Really. It was worth the $70, I tell you what. Huh? Is tummy rumbly? Oh, he's having some jelly donuts. Yeah, thank you. I kind of learned that when the Houndoom I caught the other 15 minutes ago. Alright, now I figure it's probably Tulip, right? Tulip would be next. Gita, go away. An unusual trainer. She's like the champion? Why did they make her card suck? Like, one of the most like straight up like missable cards in the entire game. Oh! Thanks for the follow. Is that Marty? I couldn't read that whole thing. I wasn't reading this either. Sure, that sounds fun. Hey, that's 30 follows too. Nice. 30 follow party? A strip. No. Then we're gonna need to tag it. You're allowed to strip on Twitch, but you have to tag it. But you're allowed to do dances without tagging now. So I guess I could strip. How you doing? I'm on like a minute delay, so if it seems like I'm not responding to you very quickly, I'm not. But I see your message. How you doing? I am not listening. Oh, thank you. Yeah, she's got battle hunger. Nimona's hunger for something else, I think. Hunger for a beatdown, I swear. Mine's growling. Tick, 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 tick! Super good. I'm gonna get Masquerade out. So cute. Dun. Kind of goomy. Excuse me, why did you just nullify my move, or what happened there exactly? I'm a little confused as to why, like, I didn't even get my move. It seemed like I just got skipped. It didn't say, like, it doesn't affect or anything like that. Like, it just said, oh, Sap Zipper, GG. What does that mean? What does Sap Zipper do? I have no freaking idea. Goomer. You got Pommo in there, dude? Probably fine. Get wrecked. How many mons you got? Okay. You moving too much. Did you just like... Return me? What are you gonna do? Not really, it's just down the street.
Take a short beauty, and then we're gonna go see if I can challenge Tulip because we're a lot stronger now. Be right back. Welcome back. We're just gonna go see if we can fight Tulip. I'm gonna switch around my party a little bit.
Dang, everybody always wants to talk to you in this damn game. It's like, I don't want to talk. Let's just go. Come on. What? Oops. I've heard that before. Is that a passing grade? That was the worst Guitar Hero I've ever played. That was like American Idol for the PlayStation 2. Nobody on this earth has played that game. Except for me. I know it. That's a deep cut. Kiss her Pokeball? I mean, I totally would too, but like, really?
man, I made a little kid cry. There's more to this? Is this? Oh my god. The variation in like what the gym tests are so insane to me. Am I gonna have to do that again? How horrible. Ouch. That sucks for you. What the hell happened in the Medichan, dude? Did he just kick himself in the head? Oopsie. Medichan, way better card than, like, an actual Amon, I guess. No, it's Indeedee. I did not think Indeedee was that big. Scale, surprising scale on that one. I did not think Indeedee was that big. Or chunky. Yo, look, he's big, he's chunky. What the hell? What are you feeding that cat, dude? That cat fat as hell. Garfield, you can see this guy be impressed with his heft. What's going on? feel like you grab him by the neck and swing him around like David and Goliath's hat. What the hell going on with that needy dude? That's what you look like?
Yo, the art for the Ndidi card looks way more flattering to that poor thing than it is in this game. Something is concerning about that model. You know? Bolo, that's what I'm thinking of. Or sling, you know? You just look like it would hurt. Like if you push him over, he'd wobble, but he wouldn't really fall over. You goofy ass moms. I don't think Indeedy looks like that. I was a little concerned seeing that. Bracelet of the day. This one's Skulls. Yes, please. Can we get on with this?
Is she fine?
I know that's like a weird question. But like, her pupils are light, you know, and like an anime that's like a... Is she blind? She could be psychic, I don't know. She's kind of like, the way she's behaving, it seems like she's blind. Thank you.
Oh, we're off to a bad start. I got no other option. Hey, it was good for something. He's got the whole house, and he wants to kick his face right behind me. That was brutal. It was a one shot.
I had that ready.
Interesting.
Gonna start with this avoided bullcrap. There we go. I'm gonna go through my whole freaking deck to find this one mon again that works.
Here we go. Here. Jigglypuff is so fucking annoying. I've literally never had her be useful for any reason. The balance is wrong. It's so wrong. Like, the first three mons in her deck are so stompable, but like the last thing is like impossible. Insane to me. It makes no sense. I'm trying to cheese this one. Houndoom is kind of, he's a great mon because he could just like, if he gets killed, you can get a free kill, you know? You just abuse that. Exposition. Bro, I spammed Fate or Destiny Bond or whatever that was. I spammed that move. Like, that wasn't really skill. That was me, like, using the suicide kamikaze move. 3 times because YOLO. But in Houndoom's case, Yolt. Because he was like there 3 times. I should just be banned off Twitch for that one. Wouldn't you agree? That was pretty bad. You heard that shit, right? No response. It's better that you didn't hear it, it's okay. Thank you.
So are we really out here? Basically, the south half of the map has been taken care of. We can see about this guy. Finally, Hound even listens. What do we do? I don't want to kill it. Okay. Again? Okay.
That's what I'm talking about! Jigglypuff. Yeah, get that shit out of here. Oh my gosh, yeah. I think this opportunity just kind of cruise across the wall for a second. The game does reward exploration quite a lot.
pointers. Right there. There's one. Thanks. I don't know how many of these there are, but that's a solid 3 right there. Good vertical in this game, actually. That's something I can say about it. Legends had a lot of, like, cliffs and stuff, but they were kind of like... They were more like obstacles, like linear obstacles, than it was like verticality to the map. Like, there'd be a big, you know, stone wall, and, like, you had to get to something that could blow up the big rock, or if you had Sneasel, you can kind of climb over. But it was just, like, to segment the map. Like, the verticality in this is, like, I don't know, it just seems like a design choice. It actually seems, like, vertical on purpose. And there's different stuff at different levels, and it actually kind of looks good up here. Like, it's the same, but looking down at stuff kind of gives you a good scale of this game. Even if stuff does kind of look like butt in the distance. There's a lot of depth to everything, and it kind of rewards you just checking stuff out. And a lot of it is like, am I supposed to be here? I don't know, but it looks cool. I mean, it's different than everywhere else I've been. You know, this texture is slightly gray, while the one over there is slightly brown, and that's basically the only difference between areas, though. I don't really think that was a compliment. I also really don't think this is... I'm breaking into the Great Crater, ladies and gentlemen. Falling down a ravine. I'm not really sure what I'm doing. Oh, I can't ride Meridon here. Well, she got me stuck in here, so... Oh shit, that's the Pokémon League? I could totally wiggle my way in there with enough time. But I'm gonna let it go. We're gonna get back on track. Right hall. She made me a new one. Camera's horrible. This one feels heavier. I love being American so much. You get away with saying that about this stuff. That's psych, by the way. I hate this country. I can't afford toys. Pokemon are really strong. Are you sure you want to battle them? I'm just saying. Oh, she can tolerate it. sorry. I can't believe my Sylveon got murked like that.
Door. Ugh, you're so annoying.
Just die. Okay. Thank you. Break it in. Yeah, what's up? I just broke in. Yeah, I can. Fight me. No. What are you? Are you fucking for real? Frustrated by that. Like, really? I gotta go all the way around? Looks like a cool place, except there's no reason for me to be here.
There's nothing here. No gym, nothing. We don't got a battle stadium, nothing to battle. Yeah, the sign isn't a real model. It's got no collision. Oh, I'm so disappointed. I love that one tree. One single fucking tree is on me. To go through level 30 something mons to get here without really skipping anything too major. So why are there level like 26s here? The scaling doesn't make any fucking sense. Like clearly they wanted you to take a specific direction through this open world game. Doesn't make any sense to me. I don't hate this game, I just really question a lot of its design choices. It's not a bad game. There's many good things about it. But there's stuff like this particular screen, where it's like, I'm in the middle of Brown Zone, and there's not even like anything interesting. There's barely a rock to look at here. Like, I'll give it to them. This is probably the smallest possible desert they could have created that still feels like a fucking desert. My point is why is it right next to the ocean? It doesn't make any sense. Because you have grassland, desert, grassland, desert, grassland, ice, and like ocean right here. Like you have a port city right next to a fucking desert, and you actually have that twice. There's two like straight up fucking deserts next to like port cities. Like, I don't even understand how Cascafera is here. It runs off the water from the mountain, I guess. But then, why does it seem like a port city? Do they send boats down there? And out that way? Because these bridges are too low for boat traffic. And so, like, you have this ocean right here. This port right here, lush green mountainside to the north and south of this like sandwiched desert just because the game needed a desert zone. Like, it just seems that like maybe if you took this desert and you stacked it on top of this desert here and put this section over there, the map would make logically a lot more sense. Like, as far as how Earth science works. This makes no logical sense. The map in Legends made sense as like an actual place. The biomes made sense. What this really ends up feeling like is just a mash of half-done ideas that are too close together. Like, why am I in a desert and then, like, I'm immediately in a dense forest. That doesn't make any sense. I shouldn't see this and then turn around to this. It doesn't flow. This should be like grassland or plains, you know? Like, is that too much of a nitpick?
I know what you mean.
It's jarring because it's just... Because of that design choice, no area in this game has any kind of identity. Like, there's several regions, but none of them feel any different than any other. Because they all feel like grassland sitting right next to a desert, sitting right next to the ocean.
Yeah, just very separate areas.
It feels like they copy and pasted the same area in this map, like, twice or three times, and just kind of rotated it. And then they put Ice Mountain in. Like, Legends definitely had personality to the four areas. The problem is it's just forgettable. The whole area is forgettable. It feels like it's all meant to be driven past or flown over with Mirrodon and not even looked at. It's like made to be that way. And that's just kind of lame. Then like... Then Mirrodon is given too early. You know? That the whole world is too big to serve the fact that you have this jet bike that can fucking fly over it all. If you're gonna build flyover country because you've given me something to fly, you might as well, like, just make me fast travel between areas. It doesn't even... You should have to play for a while in this massive world before you get Mirrodon, then. Because the world doesn't have enough time to feel big. You get Mirrodon upgraded twice and all of a sudden the world is too small. It's weird. It's just weird. Legends had a better map. Plain and simple. I just feel like this has no identity other than brown Play-Doh mud. This is my legitimate criticism about this. I feel like Game Freak has built better worlds with more identity on this console. The snow area in Legends, that place had so much character. Like the underground, like ice caves, you know, just the atmosphere of it. Mountain, the old temple, the ruins, you know. Grasslands area, classic. And that beachy area and all that stuff too. This is too much fucking talking. Like in Legends, you had a cell phone, and the only person who talked to you on that cell phone was God. This has too many people calling you. Like, at least in that one, it was basically silent. It's just a map. And people rip on Arcphone as if, like, the Pokedex or the Pokenav hasn't existed for, like, 15 years. Like, Ash Ketchum had a fucking iPhone in episode 1, dude. Complain about the kind of devices you get in this game. Please. As if the original Pokedex wasn't basically Siri. I didn't even pay attention to the mods I put out. I'm not even threatened right now. Because the scaling in this game is just caca. It doesn't make any sense. These are gross. This doesn't control well. There's no option to pick which mon you want to put out. I mean, I have so many buttons on my controller, and none of them let me choose which one I can throw. And why are you limited to these three? It's like because the game couldn't handle it if you put six out, right? Too many freaking if statements. I know it. I want to get my hands in this game's code, I swear. I just know this game is like if else, if else, if else, if else. Like, I know it. I fucking know it, dude. It's checking if-else for, like, 19 conditions on every mon. I know it. Because you can feel that. I feel it in the run. It's so miserable. There's no, like, bitwise logic, you know, nothing, like, simple. It's all complicated, I know it. Because this game is mad rushed. And I feel like this is, like, the people making Legends and the people who made this are two totally different teams. They must be. It'd be the only thing that explains the inconsistency between these two titles that came out like 6 months from each other. Like, they just don't feel like they came from the same place. After the amount I've talked about Legends on this stream, I'm gonna have to play that when I'm done with this. I'm just gonna have to. Boot up Legends and like spin it around for a few minutes. It's not gonna go away when I switch them out either. I feel like I just got, like, pranked. He sent out Revaroom, but it was, like, a tiny Revaroom. And not the one he's riding. Like, I know that's next. But is that what, like, normal Revaroom is, like, supposed to look like? Not the thing on the bottom? Is it really... But I just haven't seen, like, normal Revaroom in the game. Oh my god, look at him! He's so cute. He's flawed. He put sugar in his gas tank. Oh, I'm sorry, it's the Star Mobile. It's too many stars, I'll tear it. Gold Duck Carry? Gold Duck Hyper Carry, though?
Hey, what's up?
Bright as hell. These guys are chumps. there's not really much left on here. Figure we'll call it here for the day. Next episode, we'll certainly deal with all of the rest of everything out here in Paldea. And then I guess we'll move on to the champion and see what else is out there in those other expansions we haven't gotten to yet. As always, you have a great night.